after EA said, accept it or don't buy the game in the women's controversy in Battlefield 5, people actually did not buy the game. They were like, well, fuck you. Poor words, EA, poor words. But it's not just the people not buying the game which made Battlefield 5 flop. It's also about those people who played the game and they knew how Battlefield 5 was bad. And now everybody just hopes that Battlefield 6 can actually bring back the Battlefield that EA was always making. Oh, I'm sorry, that DICE was always making. Fuck EA. I mean, everybody knows that Battlefield is a game which is a war simulator where you have destruction, war, where you have vehicles, tanks, aircrafts flying by, and where you have amazing war happening and you are in the center of that. It's one of those things that Call of Duty can never have, is what Battlefield is having. Realism is what Battlefield was going for, and even now, realism is what Battlefield needs and wants and is still going with, but it needs to improve on that. There's a reason why Battlefield 3 and Battlefield 4 are one of the best Battlefield games. Even Battlefield 1 is pretty good, but when it comes to Battlefield 5, whoopsie, it went down. I don't know what happened there. The most important thing is how Battlefield 5 added fiction into World War II stories. It's not just about women. I mean, it never was. It's amazing to have women. I mean, why not? Just add women. It's all good. But when in the world was there a prosthetic arm in World War II? Can you please? How? Another thing that Battlefield 5 also had was maps that made zero sense. I mean, if you consider maps in Battlefield 3 or 4 or even 1, there are big maps where there are various portions where one can snipe, where one can have close quarters, and where one can drive tank. To be honest, anybody can drive tank anyway. I mean, if you're driving a tank, you literally can go anywhere you want. No restrictions whatsoever. But this is what is lacking in Battlefield 5. You see, if you see Battlefield 5 maps, they are big, oh, for sure. But they are not balanced at all. I mean, it's just big. Where's the fun? There are big open fields where you have to just rely on sniping. You cannot choose anything else. I wanted to use an LMG, an AR. Now I have to use a sniper because that's what goes in this map. It just destroys the fun, and that is what Battlefield 5 did. It's as if they have lost that innovation that they always had in Battlefield games. I mean, you can see comparison between Battlefield 3, 4 and 1. There are innovative maps, but it seems like after Battlefield 1, Battlefield 5 was like a copy, or there was no innovation at all. A lot of people actually said that Battlefield 5 seems to be like a copy of Battlefield 1, only adding certain upgrades. I think the result of having no innovation was EA's idea, because EA pushes devs to finish the game, and that didn't allow DICE to make the things they wanted to make. So they left out some of the things because they had to finish this game. If you take a look at Call of Duty, they have Warzone, which is such a huge map, but it's perfectly balanced. You have areas where you can snipe, and the moment you go near the area, you know that you might get sniped, so you have to get out of there as fast as you can. And then there are areas where it's only meant for close quarters, and sometimes it's also mixed with sniping. Somehow, Call of Duty is actually doing it much better. Another thing that felt like a drop from Battlefield game is the gun customization. Like, dude, what happened? No realism in gun customization? What is this? The customization options were so goddamn limited, as if they didn't even care to add any. Again, a perfect example would be Call of Duty Modern Warfare, where it shows that these attachments can affect your gun, whether it's good for mobility or not. Maybe it increases accuracy, maybe it decreases recoil. Those things will determine what type of attachments you should use for which type of guns, and that will play into your game. I mean, isn't it amazing that these attachments that you're adding is gonna help you become a much better shooter based on what role you're going for? Let's be honest, EA, you gotta give more freedom to DICE, otherwise Call of Duty will go ahead of you. Which I feel like they're already ahead of you. So, you're doomed. Again, the biggest thing I believe would be bringing back the game to its roots. And what I mean by roots is bringing back to fictional modern day shooter instead of going back to history. Because yeah, those can be done amazingly, but if you change certain things from it, the players will be mad, and that's what happened with Battlefield 5. Whereas in a modern setting, you are not following anything. So DICE can do whatever the hell they want, and I believe they excel in that. Some of the things that Battlefield is actually doing better is multiple stories. Small storylines, which is really cool to play through, and it actually gets your emotions running. That is one thing that Battlefield has actually doing, and I would love to see more of that. Again, Battlefield was never meant to be a single player game. It is always meant to be a multiplayer game. So many people don't care about single player, and that's why those multiple small single player storylines, I think, is perfect for Battlefield. At the end of the day, battlefield is a sandbox where you can do whatever the fuck you want. You drive a vehicle with C4s, completely destroy the building you are in, and just do crazy stuff, which is lacking right now big time in Battlefield. And even in Battlefield 1, I felt like there's not much to do. That feeling of war, it just feels like it's not there in Battlefield 5. Somehow it is empty. I mean, there is action, but it's completely unbalanced, which is no fun. I mean, won't it be fun that you damage the base of the building and the building is now falling down? That happened in Battlefield 4. What a crazy map that is. And I believe that kind of craziness needs to be there in Battlefield 6. Even choosing which player you want to play should have certain effect on the team and the game as well. I mean, isn't that what teaming up means? Instead of just being like, oh hey, I'm in a team. I'm gonna follow the greens now. I don't care about the blues. The greens are my team. So the blues can get the fuck out. It just doesn't work like that. If you have multiple teams, you should give them a reason why I should join a team and become that particular role. In the end, I would say bring back innovation. Let DICE have the freedom to do what they do best instead of giving them a barrier and forcing them to do things. Even still now, Battlefield has insane destruction, which Call of Duty does not have. It has amazing visuals, which Call of Duty still is trying to get towards. It has amazing realism in the war setting, which I believe Call of Duty still is lacking. Now, these are some of the things that I feel should be done in Battlefield 6. Now, there are more hardcore players that should be knowing more than me. So if you have any more comments, definitely do post them down in the comments below. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did like this video, leave a like. If you did not like what I said, leave a dislike. And subscribe for more awesome videos coming up very soon. Hit that notification bell icon so that you get to know when the video is coming out. I'm just gonna have my fingers crossed for Battlefield 6.